the First Lady, Mayotse Mangavu, the Vice President, Honorable General Retired Dr. C. G. D. N. Chwega, and Amazon, Vice President, Colonel Retired K. C. D. Mohari, the Speaker of Parliament, Honorable J. F. M. Mundenda, President of the Senate, Honorable M. M. Chimamanda, the Chief Justice, Honorable Luke Malala, Honorable Ministers who are here, President of the Chief's Council, Chief M. Kumalo, and other traditional leaders who are present, Honorable Members of Parliament and the Senate, senior government officials, service chiefs, all veterans of the liberation struggle, fellow Zimbabweans, inclusive of all those in the diaspora, ladies and gentlemen, comrades and friends, it is my distinct privilege and honor to once again address this august house, nearly a year since the opening of the first session of the 10th Parliament of Zimbabwe. The peace and tranquility that has prevailed since then has allowed evident results in all parts of the country. Our commitment enhanced the well-being of the people of our motherland, Zimbabwe, by entrenching unity, stability, security and development remains a key mission for my administration. My government is committed to the realization of the promises made by our ruling party, ZANU-PF. Despite enormous challenges and difficulties, as a result of the illegal economic sanctions imposed on our country, we are recording encouraging